Have you seen it? For over here, yeah. Who are you? What did you do, science? They speak a bit from these younger ladies and also go into science. I would like also to caution new students to listen maximally and then later ask the questions where you are not at the school. It is bad. You cannot do two things. You cannot listen while you're talking. So you listen, you pick the chance to ask the questions where you are not at the school. I would like to thank the organizers, the science coordinator, the science teachers of this function, and I would like you students to take this to science talk and realize what you can do. Listen carefully and discover what you can do in your life. With those few remarks, I would like to declare the science talk open.
The Uganda National Council of Science and Technology representative who shall then introduce a role model. You are welcome.
Hello.
Good morning.
You're smart. My name is Winfred Badanga. I work with the Uganda National Council for Science and Technology. I'm here representing the Executive Secretary of the Uganda National Council for Science and Technology, Dr. Peter Ndemere. Briefly, I'll tell you what the council is, what we do, and why we've come to Wanyange Girls this morning. I have a brief presentation about the council and the school visits at large. Is a semi-autonomous organization that was established by the government of Uganda in 1990. And the roles of the council are as follows: to coordinate all science and technology activities in the country, to provide advice to the government of Uganda with regard to the national S&T policies that include science funding and research management. The third role is to popularize and promote public interest and appreciation of science and technology. In line with that role, that's why we're here this morning, to popularize science, to promote public interest of science and technology. And that's why the council organizes the National Science Week. It's an annual event that takes place every year. This year, we are based in the eastern part of Uganda. Last year, we are in the central. This year, we decided to base on the eastern part of Uganda. Yesterday, and it's ending on Friday, the theme of this National Science Week is Youth in Science for Sustainable Development. Why the youth? You may be asking, why are we focusing on the youth? We want to put emphasis on the youth because there is need to create awareness among the youth in order to have a change of attitude. We want you, the youth, to have a change of attitude towards science and technology. The government policy also encourages the youth to study sciences by making science subjects compulsory at all level, and also sponsoring the best science students at high institutions of learning. The 2009 National Science Week events are as follows. We had a walk yesterday in Tororo District, a science walk, and also a launch. Then we also had a national students innovation competition and seminar at Busitema University yesterday. Then we also have the primary school fair that is taking place today in Busia district. We also have a students' dance seminar and debate taking place at the Uganda Museum today. Then we also have the school visits by the role models in science and technology, which is taking place today. We have role models who are, like we have Dr. Cole this morning, who are visiting several schools in the eastern part of Uganda, in Kaptura, Busia, Mbale, Jinja, like we are this morning, in Sironko. So, like we said here, several schools are having the same activity this morning. Then we also have a national scientific conference that will take place on Thursday in Kampala. We have the Science and Technology Policy Dialogue. We have the Science and Technology Exhibition on Thursday and Friday that will be in Wanyange. You may be wondering what a school visit and the aims. One of the aims of the school visits is to raise students' awareness and understanding of S and T issues in the socio-economic development, like one of your teachers has already mentioned. Then to enhance the interest of students in studying science subjects and choosing S and T based careers. That is our aim this morning. We want to raise your awareness and understanding, and also to make sure that you guys get an interest of taking science subjects and choosing science and technology-based careers. Why school visits? We chose school visits in order to target you, the youth, the young generation, to expose students to positive role models like Dr. Akol, then to demystify science and technology by demonstrating its relevance to students' life and well-being, bringing this thing called science from its folks so that you people know that it's not hard, it's easy, and you can do it. That is demystifying science and technology. To provide information about career paths for scientists, researchers, engineers, and technologists, and also to virilize and raise the professional profile for the local science teachers, and also to provide channels through which the interested students can be connected to opportunities in science and technology as they progress through the secondary education. Like I mentioned earlier, school visits program is we have role models that are going to visit this school. These are scientists, they are researchers, they are engineers, and we want them to give you a feel of what science is, how good it is, and how you can embrace it. At this point in time, I want to welcome our role model of the day, Dr. Akol Ann, who will take you through this answer. Thank you.
To convince you properly that you can all do science and you can be very successful in life as a scientist. So unless you're a coward, then you don't take on the challenge. But I would like to believe that you are not cowards. Are you cowards? No, you can't be cowards. So as my Daphne said, the theme for this year's science visits program is youth in science for sustainable development. My presentation this morning is to show you how science can be applied to get products from which you can get money as an individual and as a nation for sustainable development. And I will go straight to the presentation with an introduction about myself. I'm 40 years old. Is that correct? So, we were told we have to introduce ourselves to you to show you that we are ordinary people, and that a woman in science is nothing special. We are once like you. I'm the eldest of 5 children, brought up by a woman. Unfortunately, we didn't have our father to bring us up, but that was not a disadvantage, thanks to our mother. You know that saying, educate a girl, you educate a nation. She's a good example of such a person. I grew up in Entebbe and later on in Kampala, and I was fortunate. What our mother did, she was not free. She's not free. She only worked as a secretary. But she realized the best investment she could give her children, which I hope you can also do someday, is educate them in good schools. So I was fortunate to go to some of the best schools in this country. I started my primary school in Entebbe at Lake Victoria Primary School. And then she got a job in Kampala, we moved. So she enrolled us in Nakasero Primary School, and I was fortunate to get a place in Mount St. Mary's, Namagunga, where I did my secondary education from S1 to S6. And I did well enough to secure a place at the university, at Makerere University. In my time, it was only one university. Now we have to be careful to say the name, Makerere University. And I went to the Faculty of Science. I wanted to go to agriculture, but I did not get the grades to go to agriculture, so I went to science. But that did not, it was a disappointment, but that was okay. I decided to make the best of what had been given. And I studied biology. Now, at university, they've split the biology into different, what we call disciplines. You have medicine, you have agriculture, then you have botany, which is plant sciences, and then zoology, which is animal sciences. These are the more basic sciences. If you apply them, like applied plant sciences moves you into agriculture. After I finished my 3 years for the first degree, I did a postgraduate diploma in education. So I have a good background, a strong foundation in teaching, but I chose to stay at the university to teach. And then after my 2 years after I finished my diploma in education, I went to a very good university, one of the best universities in the world, called University of Cambridge, for a master's degree. I won a scholarship, not because someone gave it to me, but I saw an advert, I responded to it, and I got the scholarship from them. And all because I decided, while I was doing my first degree, I was going to make sure I got good grades. That was the only thing. Actually, that when I went to England, that was the first time I stepped on an aeroplane. And it was an experience. It was also the first time I had really been out of Uganda. And the only places I'd gone within Uganda were nothing more than 100 kilometers from Kampala. So you can imagine a very young girl leaving my family behind, going to a foreign land, but it was okay. I think I grew up a lot while I was in England. Then I came back and was working at the university. Unfortunately, I got another scholarship to go and do my third degree, the Doctorate of Philosophy in Kenya, at Kenyatta University, and a very prestigious research institute which specializes in insect science called International Center of Insect Physiology and Ecology. It's sort of fancy name, but it's basically working with insects, and that's biology. So what I've got through this is that I was not privileged. Maybe the only privilege I had was that I had a clever mother who ensured we went to good schools. And fortunately for me, I realized the opportunities I'd been given and I exploited them to get to where I am today. So you might say, oh, she went to good schools, that's where she is today. No, that's not the reason. A lot of my classmates have not got to where I am today because they did not exploit the opportunities given to them. So if there is one thing you take from me today is that exploit the opportunities that are presented to you. Being in school is an opportunity. Make the best of it and your potential will be realized. So as I said, I work for the Faculty of Science at Makerere University and I joined in 1990. Those of you who read the screen, I said my first degree was for 3 years. I went in 1987, so the program ended in 1990. But I also started working in 1990. So I started working actually before I graduated. My lecturers they convinced me to stay at the university and work rather than go to work elsewhere. I think they realized I could be a good lecturer. So I started as a teaching assistant. I was fortunate I never had to look for jobs like many of my classmates did. I've worked my way through promotion to a lecturer. Today I'm a senior lecturer and I'm also the head of the department where I was studying. But I also do some work, part-time work for other organizations that may need my help and my expertise. So being a lecturer at the university is not all about reading books or, you know, being poor. No, you can do a lot of things. And